Hey everyone, it's Caitlin and welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to be talking to you all about why I don't eat oil and why I choose not to cook with oil in my personal life. So if you watch a fair amount of What I Eat in a Day videos on YouTube, you'll notice that a lot of vegans choose not to eat oil in their diets. I'm definitely not the only one. And this can come across as kind of confusing to people, I think, especially people who are new to this lifestyle or are transitioning to a plant-based or vegan diet, because everyone's pretty much been grown up with the thinking that you need oil for cooking, that oil can be healthy for you, and that it's kind of like necessary to make certain things. But personally, I don't believe that any of that is really true. Although I tend to only see vegans avoiding the use of oil in their food, oil can definitely be vegan, besides for animal products such as lard or oils like that. Most oils are vegan. However, just because something is vegan doesn't mean that it's healthy. And especially in this case, I personally don't consider any plant-based oil to be a health food at all. So we're all raised to think that olive oil and coconut oil and avocado oil are really healthy and they have these health benefits for us. And I'm not denying that those oils do have health benefits, but hear me out. So a healthy vegan diet should be comprised of a wide variety of fruits, vegetables, legumes, and grains. And that being said, it also emphasizes a whole foods diet, which means you want to eat the whole food, not a fraction of the food. And this is the problem when it comes to oil. So if you think about it, a lot of people tend to avoid refined sugar or white flour because they don't consider that to be as healthy as whole wheat flour or unrefined sugar such as maple syrup or coconut sugar. It's the exact same thing with oil. Oil has to come from something. It doesn't just appear in thin air. So that olive oil that you use actually came from whole olives, or that coconut oil came from coconut meat. The same with avocado oil, rapeseed oil, canola oil, etc. And while some oils are ranked as a scale of being healthier than others, and I will agree that some oils are healthier than others, such as canola oil, which is usually completely genetically modified and it's a partially hydrogenated oil, so that's just gross and you really don't want to mess with that. However, I still wouldn't choose to eat olive oil or coconut oil in my food because when you think about it, oil is essentially oil. If you look at the nutrition facts for any oil, it will all have the same amount of grams of fat because it's pure fat. And you could choose to eat half of an avocado or you could have a few teaspoons of olive oil. And what do you think you're getting more nutritional benefits from? The same thing goes with coconuts and coconut oil or olives and olive oil. And that brings me to my next point. A lot of people who don't eat oil tend to eat a higher carb, low fat diet, which I think can confuse some people into thinking that all fat is evil and that we shouldn't eat fat. And that is not true at all. While there are some people that thrive on an extremely low-fat diet, personally, I believe that the majority of the population does need to have some fat in their diet in order to be healthy. Like, your brain is made of mostly fat. You need to eat a proper amount of fat in your diet in order to have healthy skin and hair. But that percentage of fat does vary for people. So I think each person should generally experiment to see what they feel best on. But that being said, just because you're not eating oil doesn't mean you can't eat fat. For example, I still get tons of healthy fat in my diet through the use of avocado, nut butter such as peanut butter or almond butter, tahini, which is sesame seeds, and I also use chia seeds and flax seeds as well. So there are plenty of ways to still get those healthy fats that you need without the use of a refined product. Then the next thing that I see is that when people find out that oil is technically bad for them, they think that they can never eat oil ever again. And I'm going to be honest with you, there are some people out there who refuse to eat any type of oil. And if that type of lifestyle works for them, more power to them, I think that's great. However, even though I avoid oil, I still eat oil from time to time. I don't use oil in my personal cooking or when I'm baking recipes for myself or for my friends. However, if I buy a product from the grocery store that already has oil in it, I'm okay with it. I just don't consider it to be like a main staple in my diet. Like, for example, I have some store-bought granolas that I put on my banana ice cream, and the majority of those contain oil, but I'm not really using that much of it, and although the food does contain oil, I still enjoy the food, and I'm gonna continue eating it. And also, when I'm going out to eat, I don't go out of my way to make sure that the food is completely oil-free. If the restaurant advertises that they can do it, then I wouldn't mind asking for an oil-free meal. However, when you go to a restaurant that may have more limited vegan options, sometimes ordering oil-free and ordering vegan just isn't possible. And for me personally, I don't go out to eat too much. So when I do, I'm not really stressed about the oil content in my food, and I'm more focused on enjoying the delicious vegan food that I am eating and the time that I'm spending with my friends and family while I'm out. So long story short, yes, oil is bad for you, but there's a lot of foods that are bad for you that you can still eat and enjoy and live a perfectly healthy life. A major aspect of a healthy diet is the ability to be comfortable with treating yourself and eating unhealthy food as well as healthy food and finding the balance that works best for you. So hopefully that makes sense to you all, but before I end the video, I did want to give a few tips on cooking without oil. Because a lot of people tend to ask questions in my what I eat in a day videos and how I cooked a certain item without oil. If you guys want me to do a more in-depth video on this, let me know in the comments below of this one, but I'm just gonna give you a few quick tips. So first off, I think the most common thing is people think in order to saute anything in a pan, you need oil, and that is easily substituted by water. I just put a small amount of water, usually about 1 to 2 tablespoons, before I put my vegetables in it. And the small amount of water still allows the vegetable to get more of a fry on it. You can also purchase nonstick pans, which sometimes don't even require any liquid at all, and you don't have to worry about the vegetable or whatever you're cooking sticking to the bottom of the pan. Additionally, in baking, instead of using a nonstick cooking spray or greasing your pan in coconut oil before you put a bread or muffin tin in, you can just use parchment paper, which is an oven-safe paper that you just line the pan with, and then your bread will easily come out and you don't have to use any oil. I know people also sell silicone muffin tins. I don't personally own them because I don't cook muffins very often, but it's just like a reusable muffin liner, or you could also purchase those paper ones as well, but I just think the silicone ones are more eco-friendly. And finally, some recipes just call for oil and people really aren't sure how to substitute that oil. So for me personally, I think I do have some more cooking experience, so it's a little bit easier for me to know what I can and cannot substitute for oil. But generally speaking, you can usually substitute the oil for another type of fatty whole plant food. So for example, if you're making cookies that require oil, you could use the same amount of liquid volume of peanut butter or almond butter, and that usually works pretty well. If you want to lower the fat content, you can usually sub oil for applesauce, but this gets a little more complicated, and I think other YouTube videos have been made, so I will try to find some helpful videos or links to share with you all in the description of this video as well. Alright guys, and that sums up this video on why I don't eat oil for the most part. And I hope you all found it helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below and I will try to get back to you. And I will see you later. Bye!